The latest CBSN Originals Reverb documentary is called A City Under Surveillance, and it investigates how new high-tech policing tools like facial recognition can land innocent people behind bars. Here's a preview.
Tonight, the community is speaking out following a very violent weekend in Detroit. They are raising their concerns about
Detroit consistently tops the list of America's most dangerous cities.
I never want another family to go through what me and my family went through when Denzel was murdered. But I thank God for facial recognition, because facial recognition helped solve my cousin's murder.
To combat crime, the police have implemented facial recognition technology and a network of surveillance cameras, arguing digital policing will keep residents safe.
The problem is the underlying premise that the city pushes, that this is a solution.
But critics say the technology is racist and could land innocent people behind bars.
The software is not accurate at all when it comes to predominantly black cities.
Where would you be right now if the judge looking at the photos made the same mistake that the artificial intelligence did?
I'd be in prison right now. For sure.
CBSN Originals producer Elaisha Stokes joins us now to talk about this. So, Elaisha, how and why is the Detroit Police Department using this surveillance technology?
Sure. So this surveillance technology is really used throughout the city. There's facial recognition software that's used to identify potential suspects. And then they're also using a network of surveillance cameras that are throughout the city on private businesses. The project is known as Project Greenlight. And the reason they're using this is because Detroit has one of the highest crime rates in the country. And police really argue that this is going to help them keep dangerous people off the streets and lower the crime rate.
Okay, so that's one side of the argument. What's the other side? What are people most concerned about when it comes to facial recognition technology being used in law enforcement?
Sure. So, I mean, beyond our civil liberties, do we really want to be watched all day, all the time? There's also the issue that when it comes to facial recognition in particular, it has a failure rate of 96% when it comes to black and brown faces. And of course, Detroit has the largest population of African-American residents of any city in the country. And so this is very relevant. It is landing innocent people behind bars. And that's really what our documentary explores. The case of Michael Oliver, one young man who had his life just turned upside down when he was wrongly identified for a crime he did not commit based on this software.
So then, Elaisha, what is the future of this technology looks like? And I guess more importantly, the future of this technology being used by law enforcement.
Yeah, I mean, we saw this technology used even this summer in New York City during Black Lives Matter protests. There are some real issues with our civil liberties being eroded. There are 13 cities across the country, such as Boston and San Francisco, that have already banned this technology. It's important to note, though, that these are majority white cities, and it really is problematic technology when it comes to people of color. And so, you know, I anticipate that we're going to see this software under more scrutiny. But at the same time, you know, police really want to use it. They argue that it is helping them fight crime.
Elaisha Stokes, thank you. It sounds like a very interesting documentary. Appreciate it.
Thank you so much.
So you can stream A City Under Surveillance right now on cbsnews.com/policing, or you can watch it this Sunday at 8 p.m. Eastern on CBSN.